Privilege at this time to do the induction for Steve DeMarchi. All right. Steve DeMarchi would deliver a parcel for Prestige Couriers in the late 1980s, and the hit single "When I'm With You" would come on the radio. They'd have Chum AM on. The song would play, and I'd say, "That's me on the radio." They'd look at me and say, "Sure it is. Just put the box over in the corner, you idiot." Steve said that. I wouldn't have said that. I delivered Courier from the airport when I was in high school. I know what that's like. It was indeed Steve playing guitar and singing on Sheriff's 1983 number one Canadian hit. A couple of years later, the band was out of work as punk and new wave changed the musical landscape overnight. DeMarchi and lead vocalist Freddie Kirchy took jobs as couriers while they awaited the chance to deliver more hits. In the meantime, they invested $70,000 in a 16-track studio in the basement of the DeMarchi home. DeMarchi and his multi-talented brother Dennis and Kirchy recorded a whole album in case they ever got another chance. A group of touring music execs in town for a convention couldn't believe how much sound the trio were able to get out of 16 tracks when 48 was the norm for professional studios. One day, out of the blue, Capitol Records president Dean Cameron called saying, "You're going to have a hit." A Las Vegas DJ had started playing "When I'm With You" for a Guess the Band contest. The song took flight again, climbing into the top 10. DeMarchi and Kirchy quit the courier business, headed off to do multiple American radio interviews. They hooked up with the three founding members of Seattle's Heart to form Alias, a reference to the fact they were composite versions of Sheriff and Heart under another name. One of the songs they'd written at DeMarchi's home while couriers, "More Than Words Can Say," eventually hit number 2 on the Billboard's Top 100 and number 1 on the Adult Contemporary chart list. Steve's two biggest hits are in rotation in classic radio formats, have been used in numerous TV ads, including on the Super Bowl, and are part of the Time Life music compilation sold around the globe. Alias's demise was as unexpected as its birth. The record started to do well, then grunge and alternative hit, and the bottom fell out again. DeMarchi has since toured the world, working as a side musician with the Cranberries. Steve well remembers the night Keith Richards and Ronnie Wood and Charlie Watts knocked on the dressing room door to introduce themselves and say, "Welcome to the tour." He spent 2 years helping lead singer Dolores O'Riordan write and record her solo record, part of which was recorded at Metalworks on Mavis Roads, while Alanis Morissette was singing background vocals on a Freddie Kirchy cover of Brown Eyed Girls. She asked Steve what it was like to have a number one hit record. He got to ask her the same question a few years later at an awards show in Europe. Steve DeMarchi has played everywhere from the Mississippi Bell, the Locomotion, and Superstars in his hometown to the Vatican, where he played with the Cranberries before 200,000 people at a Christmas celebration that featured an 85-piece orchestra. He's also appeared on The Tonight Show with Johnny Carson and more than a half a dozen times on the version hosted by Jay Leno. He even played the Nobel Prize concert when he and the Cranberries shared a stage with Shania Twain and Phil Collins. "There's something I never would have dreamed of as a kid playing the local bars around here," he says. All of that and more has earned Steve a well-earned place on Mississauga's Music Walk of Fame. Ladies and gentlemen, Steve DeMarchi.
Thank you. Wow. Thanks so much, everybody. This is pretty incredible. Again, it's something that you never really expect to happen in your career when you start playing guitar when you're a little kid. You just want to play guitar and have some fun. And I can't believe all the things I've done in my career, you know? I've had a lot of high moments. I've had a lot of low moments. We won't talk about the low moments, but this is definitely right on top for me. I never really expected this. There's a lot of people I can thank, but the number one person I do have to thank is my mom, who's here. Not only for all the support that she's given me, but we actually recorded a rock record in her basement that took months. And I'm a pretty loud guitar player, so I play pretty loud. I'm sure my neighbors don't like me too much, but that's okay. So anyway, I'd like to thank all the guys in Sheriff, all the guys in Alias, Cranberries, Dolores O'Riordan. This is just kind of an amazing career. It's something that I never really expected this to happen. So all the staff, all the people, Bonnie, it was great meeting you today. And Hazel, what a pleasure to see you today. Jim, thank you so much. And what can I say? This to me means, well, as the title of our song, it means more than words can say. Thank you so much, everybody. Thanks.
Thanks. Before we do the next inductee, I'd just like to a little housekeeping thing. Mayor Crombie has certificates for all the award winners. So what we'd like to do is we'll do the induction, and then I'd like to invite all of the people awarded up onto the stage, along with Mayor Crombie, to receive their certificates from her. And if Councillor Starr and MP Spengman could come up as well at that time, I'd be very appreciative of.
Where's that? Get out of Denny. Steve? Get out of Denny. Where's Anna? Who's Anna? Yeah, the sister.
Where's Anna?
Right there. Yeah, very nice.
It's still hard.
at 6 o'clock in the morning to sleep without you.